In this video, we will discuss about flowchart. Flowchart is a graphical representation. Means, whatever the sequence of operations of programs are there, that you can represent it in a picture format. It has got its own symbols and it shows the steps in a sequential order. And it is also used for showing the flow of algorithms and workflow or a process. The flowchart has got various kinds of boxes, and these are connected with the arrows. Now let us understand what are these symbols which we are using in flowchart. Here in this video, we can see different symbols used in flowchart. Now let us try to understand where what type of flowchart should be used. So here in the beginning or in the first row, you can see an oval shape which is used to define the start or a beginning and end of the flowchart. And in the second row, you can see a parallelogram that is used to define the input and output, such as read operation or input two numbers. You can define it in parallelogram. And when you output, such as output area, you can define it in parallelogram. Similarly, rectangles are used for arithmetic operations. So you are calculating sum of two numbers, sum equal to A plus B. You define it in rectangle. So diamond is used for branching or looping statements. Suppose assume that you are calculating or you are just comparing A and B for largest of two numbers. If A is true, what it has to perform, and if B is true, what it has to perform. That you can define it with the diamond shaped symbol. Now in this video, you can see arrows which is showing the direction in which the data is flowing or the program is executed. And in the circle, so you can use a circle to connect your flowchart within a page. That means if your flowchart is at the bottom of the page and it is still continued, so you can just link it or you can continue it on the same page by using this symbol. And there in the flowchart, in this particular circle, you can use AB to represent from where it continues. Similarly, you have an off-page connector that you are using to connect between two pages. If it continues in the next page, you can use an off-page connector. If your program got a function, you can use this particular rectangle with rectangular boxes in this shape for defining it as a function, in a function call as well as to define the function. So you are using this type of rectangular boxes. And preprocessors, you are using this symbol. Sometime you are using it for loop also. And suppose assume that you are defining a comment, you are using such symbols. This is how you can use the symbols in a flowchart. Now let us discuss about the flowchart, or we will take some examples of flowchart. We have already seen the algorithm of this calculating sum of two numbers. Here you see ovals we have defined for start and end, and parallelogram we have used it for A and B to read the data. You can write the in single parallelogram also as read A comma B. That also you can define. And in the rectangular boxes, you can see the sum is calculated. And here one mistake is there. This diagram has some mistake. Here there should be parallelogram to print that sum. This is one of the example. Next one more we will see. Here we input three numbers. Start and stop, it is given in a parallelogram. Sometime the shapes may have be designed in a different software with the different shapes. Then we input three numbers. Unlike this, here you see three numbers input in one parallelogram. Then we calculate average and we print the average. Next, in this one we are inputting, here you see instead of input the read statement is used. It is same, it's some English word you can use, read b comma h for breadth and height, and area is calculated in rectangular boxes. And again here you see, here it was given as output, here it is given as a print. See, I have kept three different types of flowcharts so that you can, you should understand that by using the wording is not important here. You can change the wording, but the method in which you write, that should be, or that symbols or a method in which you write, that is very important. Here you see these are connected with the arrows, means it is showing the sequence in which, or the order in which it is executed. Next, one more example we will take. This is related to the branching instruction. That is, I have taken this. Here I have used a flowchart which is comparing three numbers A, B, C and check whether A is greater than B or B is greater than C, means which is the largest number. For this one I have kept both algorithm, this side I have kept algorithm and this side I have kept flowchart. So flowchart starts with start and here algorithm starts with start, and read these three numbers. Same concept comes here, A, B, C we read here. Then in the initial stage what we are doing is we are comparing A and B. Of course, if the A is B, then we have to compare A with C. That means if A is greater than B, it will, yes will be selected, correct? And it will go and compare A and C. If A is greater than C, if A is greater than C, then it will print A is greater. Otherwise, it will go and it will print C. Suppose assume that A is less than B, then no is the path for this execution. Here you see, then it will check B with C, means B is already larger here, it will be compared with C. Still B is greater, then it will print B. Otherwise, that is if C is greater, then it will print C, and it will end the program here. This is how the flowchart defines a program. Here you see the algorithm also, it checks A and B. If it is true, then it checks C, A and C. If it is greater, then it will print A. Otherwise, if it is false, it will print C. So that will satisfy this line. Just a minute. That will satisfy this line. Means, if A is greater than B, this statement, then yes, it will go for next statement. If C is greater than A, sorry, if A is, sorry, just I will repeat again. I will start from this. First we read the input statement, then we will check A is greater than B. If this condition is true, this side it will go, otherwise this side it will go. So here that is why it is given if true. If false, it will be continued this side. Okay, so this is true, that means it will check A is greater than C. If A is greater than C, then it will print A is greatest number, like this here. If it is false, it will print C is greatest number. Then if this condition is false, it will go by no path, and here it will check B and C. If B is greater than C, it will print B is greater. If it is condition is false, that is no, it will print C is greater. Then it will end. This is how you can define the execution of the flow, execution of the program in flowchart and algorithms. Thank you.